is when he shows up here in Tampa. The production and the staging of the convention. So the way a host committee works relative to the COA, we have to go raise $55 million, all private money. We take no taxpayer funding to put on this convention. So when the host committee says, we've got our money, we're ready to go, the COA then calls us and says, okay, you've got to build out the stage. You've got to come into the forum and you've got to build the stage 4 feet high. We want it to be red, white, and blue. We want the lights to look this way. You guys just write the check. If I were to come in and say, I want the stage, I think it should be 2 feet high. I think it should be, 45 feet longer. They're going to say, we really appreciate your opinion, Ken. Please go back to your office and go raise more money. And that's what we do. We raise money. So we then turn around and we pay for all of the infrastructure for the convention. It's much like a Super Bowl host committee, if you want to draw the parallel, or the Olympic host committee. You've got the IOC, the International Olympic Committee, or the NFL. Those organizations are much like the RNC, the Republican National Committee. Then you've got an Olympic host committee, and you have a Super Bowl host committee. The mission of the Super Bowl host committee, when it was here last time, was rent Raymond James Stadium, pay the rent. Strike the field, hang the lights, make sure the power's on that day, make sure you show up with all your volunteers. Those are the roles that we fulfill. The NFL, different mission. They're involved with the teams, the Green Bay Packers, the Tampa Bay Bucks, we hope one day, again, soon. I'm not commenting on the quality of the new coach or the team, just I hope that they get to the Super Bowl again. So that's the same type of thing we do. We're not involved with Mitt Romney, Newt Gingrich, Ron Paul, Rick Santorum, who knows, maybe Donald Trump is still going to get in the race. It depends who is the candidate, and that's what their mission is. That's what the RNC does. So we are independent agencies. We don't share financial resources. We have separate bank accounts, separate legal structures. Everything is separated. But we do have an agreement that says we will do certain things for you, COA, in exchange for you picking Tampa as the host city. Now we have to go through and check those 150 boxes, all those promises we made to get the convention here in Tampa. The convention impact, this is really phenomenal. The convention actually starts on the 26th now. If you read the paper, I think yesterday, there will be a big kickoff event not too far from where we are here. We're not ready to announce the actual venue. It's probably the worst kept secret in Tampa, but everybody keeps talking about it. There will be a big welcome event here in Pinellas County. The official venue has not been set yet, but it will be announced very soon. So the actual day will be August 26th, and that will kick off the convention. That will be our welcome event. 10 billion media impressions. It's really hard to, it's so funny, you don't want to ever overstate the case, but it's hard to overstate the case of what the media impact is for this event.